Hi, thanks for joining me for my lightning talk. My name is Tom Mock. I'm the customer enablement lead at RStudio. I'm going to be talking about Apache Arrow and dplyr for efficient exploratory data analysis. We're here at the Arrow kind of conference, so don't want to go too deep into Arrow itself because I'm sure you heard about a lot of it, but the Arrow R package is essentially an interface to datasets via the Arrow backend, and it has very deep integration with dplyr, both group by, summarize, mutate, filter, select, all these different functions are available. Arrow data can also be handed off to DuckDB with the toDuckDB function, and this allows you to use dbplyr for even more dplyr commands against these data sets. So a lot of power here between Arrow, dplyr, and DuckDB integration. The whole concept of today is that the thought is that you're probably working with bigger data. So data, and specifically a lot of local files, are getting bigger. Many data warehouses or data lakes also use flat file storage, things like CSV or even Parquet or JSON. And while they might have their own query environments, you still often end up with very large extracts that you have to work with in your local environment. So how do you work with these extracts that aren't kind of preloaded into a database and might end up being bigger than what you want to pull into memory? This is where Arrow can kind of save your bacon and kind of be very helpful to you. So I'm going to walk through these examples. I'm going to load three different libraries, the Arrow package for interface to Arrow, dplyr for data analysis, and then TikTok, not for watching cute dog videos like I do normally, but to help time out some of our computations and show just how fast they are. So onto Arrow, there are great examples of data analysis on big data, things like 2 billion rows in the Arrow documentation. But for today, I want to focus on bigger, big-ish data, but manageable data. So if we were to use the raw CSVs, this would be almost 2.2 gigabytes of data. But because we're using Arrow, we can use much more efficient Parquet files. So these are compressed, and on disk, they're about 82% smaller than the CSVs at under 400 megabytes. Again, it's not that big, but it's 372 columns and 1.1 million rows, so plenty big for today's example. The data set we're actually working with is from the nflfastR group. You can get all the data from their GitHub link, and they have it in Parquet or CSV or other formats. And to make it even more efficient within Arrow, I've partitioned it by season, so each season gets its own subdirectory within the directory and has its own data.parquet file. So this will make Arrow even more efficient working with this data. The first step in this process is we essentially need to put the arrow onto the string, knock the arrow, and get ready. So we can prepare a dataset to be opened or used with arrow open dataset. This is we're passing the data dash parquet directory and saying it's partitioned or separated out by season. And Arrow then knows, oh yeah, there's 23 datasets we're working with. Here's all of the potential column names that you can work with, but we haven't really done anything. We've just kind of aimed Arrow at it and said it's available now. We can then perform computations with dplyr, and this will send those computations on disk and query them against the dataset on disk as well. So we can run this operation and I can print it out. But as you might see here, you know, there's nothing really to see. It's just telling me, oh, it's a query, there's three columns you're returning and the call types, but we don't actually see the values. So we're just reporting back the three columns and the type of the columns themselves. So if we wanted to actually see the values or pull it into memory, we could use the collect function. So this will allow us to finally pull the data off of disk into memory and display the result. So that same summarized data frame, the query, we can collect it, and now it's in memory and we can do other things with it. We could arrange it and see the top teams, or we could even put it into a ggplot. It's in memory at this point because we have collected the data off of disk into memory, and now we can treat it like any other data frame. So that's option one. But you can imagine that on very, very large data sets, it may not be efficient to, you know, collect it all at once. However, for this data set with 1 million rows, we can perform a query against all of it, filter, group by, summarize, and then collect just the summary and do that extremely fast. So in about 140 milliseconds, we can look at every single row in the data set, summarize it out by groups, and then pull it across and pull it into memory. So that's very, very efficient. However, if you're not doing this summarization, essentially shrinking down the data set, your collect step might be pulling in a lot of data into memory. So do you always have to collect to do that? and you don't. You don't always have to collect it, but that is a good step for pulling into memory and doing other things with it. So for better exploratory data analysis, where you're kind of exploring it and not wanting to collect all the data at once, or it might be too large to collect and be comfortable with, you can use the toDuckDB function. So this will essentially convert the arrow data set that's on disk and treat it like a DuckDB database that you can perform either SQL queries or dplyr queries against. So here, again, very, very quick, about 280 milliseconds, we can take the data set, select some columns, filter it, send it to DuckDB, and then do another filter. And now we actually get something returned back. We get values that we can see. Again, we haven't pulled all of it into memory. We're just returning the top 10 rows of our query. So still very fast, still very efficient, and you can do interactive exploratory data analysis like this very, very efficiently. DuckDB also adds more options. While arrow is very powerful combined with dplyr alone, there are certain things it just doesn't support today. So this window function of essentially counting within a mutate isn't supported today in arrow. However, if you select some columns, send those to DuckDB on disk, then do your mutate group by summarize, it's supported because dplyr and DuckDB have a large amount of functions in addition to what's available just with arrow. So you can see here again, we're seeing 10 rows and there's more rows on disk that we can explore back. Again, the big benefit here is more functions and true exploratory data analysis without having to collect it all into memory all at once. So all together now, you have dplyr, arrow, and DuckDB that form a powerful trifecta for efficiently and effectively exploring these large data sets. Once you've explored and you're ready to bring, you know, relatively large data sets into memory, it's also fast. So here I've defined a few different functions, basically reading in a data set with arrow, with data table, with vroom, with arrow CSV's reader, and with the reader R package. All of these are pulling in the same number of rows and columns, so 50,000 rows, 372 columns. They're all essentially doing the same thing, even though they're doing it with their own functions within the packages. We can then benchmark those and say, okay, do all of these 10 times and report back how long it took on average, or in this case, the median. So we can see that not only is arrow really efficient for this exploratory data analysis, getting subsets and small queries and dplyr filters and group bys and everything else, but it's also extremely fast at pulling data into memory, just reading it all in without having to do like a filter step. So read arrow from opening the data set itself was the fastest, about 171 milliseconds. Vroom, CSV, arrow were next and very close with 230 and 350. Data table was also really fast at under a second. And then the readr package was the slowest when we did lazy, basically saying, read it all in, don't use the vroom as the back end. So the takeaway for me here is, again, the beauty of arrow is not just that it's fast at doing one thing. It's not just fast at reading in data. It's not just fast at sending queries, but it's fast at all of it. It's fast at exploring the data before you even have to wait to read in all the data set just to do a simple query. And you don't have to wait or procure a workstation or environment that has enough memory to read it all in and compute on it. You can perform exploratory data analysis on these data sets, find the subsets you want to grab, and then pull them in very efficiently or grab subsets and summaries of them. So that being said, go out, use arrow and dplyr with DuckDB for outrageously efficient exploratory data analysis. Thanks for hanging out with me for a few minutes. If you want to look at the code here or the slides, you can visit it at jthomasmock.github.io/arrow-dplyr. Thanks and have a good week.